Ramaphosa said there will be an infrastructure spend drive, yet the budget said they're cutting infrastructure to fund higher education. How do you marry this two?
This is what the reality is, that the words do not necessarily match the numbers. The cutbacks on infrastructural investment is not the fact that the government is cutting back on infrastructural investment, it's just that it is not increasing it. It's by cutting back on other areas of expenditure, including public sector remuneration. Instead, the share of government infrastructure spending is remaining constant. Of greater concern is the fact that public sector infrastructural investment, including both government and parastatals, is set to be a lot lower over the next 3 years than what was budgeted for last year. To be precise, in last year's budget, the projected infrastructural expenditure by the public sector was set to be 947 billion rand. This year it's said to be 834 billion rand, and a lot of that reduction can be attributed not so much to central government itself spending less on capital, but also to state-owned enterprises spending a lot less, simply because they don't have the money, they are short of cash. And in respect of the government itself, the lack of infrastructural investment spending arises out of the fact that two-thirds of municipalities have spent 85% or less of their capital budgets, either through inefficiency or a lack of skills or through corruption. I don't know what the reason is.
Now, lastly, you mentioned that the South African building sector is in its weakest and, you know, its weakest space. Just give a brief outlook on this and the challenges it faces.
One needs to distinguish between building, different between residential building, non-residential building, and civil engineering. The worst of the lot in the last few years has been civil engineering, where work from the government has just, most civil engineering industry depends most on the government and state-owned enterprises rather than on the private sector, and there that has just diminished dramatically. As far as non-residential building goes, that has fallen off quite sharply this past year. Clearly, it's a lagging indicator of the overall economy, and the downturn in the economy in 2015 and 2016 obviously manifested itself in less building activity a year later, because, you know, it's only when project planners see activity falling that they decide to cut back on future plans, and so you get that lag filtering through. The positive aspect is that in the last couple of months there has been a little bit of a revival in non-residential building plans passed. On the residential side, the downturn has not been as severe as it was in non-residential or civil engineering, but conversely, building plans passed are not terribly optimistic either. Clearly, what has been holding back plans for new residential building is the fact that house price increases have been very subdued, so that project developers do not see all that much potential for a decent return on an investment right now. The last few months have seen a little bit of a revival in house prices, but they are still, until now, have still been less than inflation. Hopefully there will be a gradual increase, and with the possibility of further interest rate cuts, it'll gradually pick up, but I don't think you'll see a major upswing before 2019 at the earliest.
I think that the sector is feeling encouraged by some of the changes that have happened in the country of late. There is renewed optimism, and it's always interesting when there's optimism, suddenly people feel a little bit more confident. The lucky thing that we have is people love our product. They like buying cement, but they're not going to build unless they're feeling confident. So we have seen a little uptick through December, January, and we're seeing it in February as well. So there is a renewed sense of optimism. I think people are building again, and that is encouraging. The budget itself, on balance in the circumstances, it's not a bad budget for us. There are some encouraging signs in there, some others that are going to take a little bit more time to work through. But there are green shoots. I think government's acknowledgement that there's a need for investment in infrastructure is still very much there. But the finance minister obviously had a relatively difficult task to balance the demands with revenue collection. We're hoping, and we're seeing this as a little bit more of a medium-term play, that as the work continues in government to fix our SOEs, to get government departments functioning properly, to making sure that everybody from local municipalities all the way up to national government is spending, that slowly but surely the industry will see the benefits. So cautiously optimistic as industry, I think, certainly cautiously optimistic as AfriSam. But we're going to have to be patient. This is not a quick fix. You can't just flick a switch and everything is back to where we were back in 2007, 2008.